Well, as politicians return to Canberra for the final sitting fortnight of the hung parliament, the Gillard government has suffered a disastrous collapse in support from men. The government slumped 7% among male voters after the Prime Minister reignited the gender debate, and it's led to a fall in Labor's primary vote to 29%. Intensifying pressure on Julia Gillard's besieged leadership, the poll shows that under Kevin Rudd, Labor's primary vote would jump 11 points to a competitive 40%. Lots of numbers to get through, so let's go straight to Canberra now to our chief political reporter, Kieran Gilbert. And morning to you, Kieran.
Nina, good morning. This is not the poll result that the Prime Minister wanted today of all days, as Labor MPs return to Canberra for the final parliamentary sitting fortnight of this hung parliament, the 43rd parliament. As you say, some numbers to get through, let's do it. The primary vote for the Gillard government has fallen to 29%. Psychologically, very damaging for Labor MPs, with the return of a primary vote with a two in front. Now, you compare that to a Rudd-led Labor government, according to this poll, that would see a primary vote of 40%, 11 points better if Rudd was leader. Now, on a two-party basis, that translates to, well, under Julia Gillard currently, 57-43 on a two-party preferred basis, and under Kevin Rudd, well, 50-50. And as you've quite rightly pointed out, Nina, this will do nothing but intensify the pressure on Julia Gillard's besieged leadership, as the crucial final fortnight of Parliament is about to begin.
That disastrous number on the primary vote, Kieran, 29%, attributed to this collapse in support amongst male voters.
Reigniting the gender battle last week with that speech to the Women for Gillard event has backfired, and backfired in a big way. There's been no statistical shift in support among women, a 1% rise, but statistically within the margin of error. Let's look at it for you. The number among male voters, it's collapsed 7 points from 31 to 24% among male voters. So that is what has driven this fall in the primary vote. And as I say, the last thing that Prime Minister Gillard would want right now. In terms of the preferred Labor leader, well, this is no dramatic surprise when you look at the primary vote, but the preferred Labor leader, Kevin Rudd, 58% to Julia Gillard, 32%. 58% Kevin Rudd to 32% Julia Gillard as preferred Labor leader. On the preferred PM, well, Tony Abbott has extended his lead on that front as well.
Talking about Kevin Rudd, what's the feeling amongst his position that he wants to return to the top job, but he wants members of the Gillard camp to own that decision?
Yeah, this is not really, I suppose this puts names to what we had expected. Kevin Rudd has said he's not going to challenge, so if there is going to be some shift, senior ministers in the Gillard camp would have to move. We've known that. Well, Kevin Rudd in the News Limited papers today has apparently warned colleagues that he would want senior ministers, not just Bill Shorten, but others, including the likes of Greg Combey, Penny Wong, Jenny Macklin, to own any change. Now, this reflects his hope that if he was to return, that he would be leading a united party and not a party which is continuing to be plagued by division. Just a month or two out, possibly even sooner from the federal election. Now, the Prime Minister arrived at a local government event here at Parliament House last night, flanked by some supporters, and was deflecting questions on the leadership. Let's have a listen, as well as some interesting comments from some other Labor figures, key supporters of Julia Gillard.
Thank you.
Right.
Thank you.
I was just thinking
that.
Thank you.
Thank you. Leadership.
Very well.
Do you have any concerns at all about Mr. Rudd?
Hello, hello.
None at all.
Minister, should the Prime Minister quit?
Oh, that is stupid.
Why not?
She's the best person to lead the government.
Should the Prime Minister quit for the good of the Labor Party?
Absolutely not.
Mm. Why not?
Well, because I don't see an alternative to her.
Could the alternative be Kevin Rudd?
No, not really, no.
Is it too late for that?
Oh, look, quite frankly, I think that 5 minutes after he's elected leader, the opposition will be stressing the immigration changes that he engineered, and that's Western Sydney.
Mr. Green, do you agree with John Murphy that Kevin Rudd should come back?
I've got one here.
with the local government association, the great organisation, that's what I'm here for tonight, and then I'll...
But a new poll shows that Kevin Rudd would save so many seats. Kimmy, do you agree with John Murphy that Kevin Rudd should come back?
Not tonight, boys and girls.
Why not?
Most of them deflecting the questions, including the Prime Minister, but Laurie Ferguson, one of her backers from Western Sydney, saying that a Rudd return wouldn't have the impact that the Labor government desires. That is obviously not the view of many other backbenchers, including two that spoke out at the weekend, John Murphy and Darren Cheeseman, who called on the Prime Minister to stand aside to make way for Mr Rudd, Nina.
Okay, Kieran, plenty to dissect this morning, and certainly throughout the next fortnight with the last session of Parliament. Chat to you again soon.